next guest is so passionate about being confident and positive in your own body. Bold and brazen, she's body confidence personified. Emmylou MacCarthy is the no-holds-barred blogger who stripped down for a strut down Melbourne's busy Bourke Street Mall. Thousands follow her every move and subscribe to her mantra that confidence is contagious. Please welcome speaker, writer, TV presenter and all-round badass, Emmylou. Absolute rock star. I would love to have a tiny bit of the confidence that you have. You're amazing. Oh. What was it like stripping down to your knickers and your bra and walking through Melbourne?
Can I just say it was actually quite gnarly. Like, I've done a lot of bathers shoot and I've done bathers in Bourke Street Mall, and that for some reason didn't feel as confronting. But when you're doing something like lingerie, it's a private thing,
sure.
Right? And then also, it happened to be one of the most brutally cold days as well. So everyone was in parkas and I was like, wow, it's cold and it's dark, but how amazing is this going to look? The bright pink, your skin, you know, like just... And the smile brightening up everyone's commute in the morning.
Which brings me, what sort of reaction did you get?
You know what? It was beautiful. Not one derogatory comment, not one sort of, you know, eyeball up and down, nothing like that. It was very much like, whoa, and more like she's crazy. It's freezing cold. But nothing that made you feel silly or, you know, or feel bad about yourself at all. There was lots of smiles.
Your mantra is that confidence is contagious.
Yeah.
What do you mean by that? And did you find that other people suddenly stripped off to their underwear because it was contagious?
You know what? I think it gets related back in different ways. So confidence is contagious. When you hang around someone that's really positive, that's, you know, always going after things, you start to just... It starts to rub off on you, right?
Yeah. Mm.
But I think the big thing has been the courage, you know, because confidence, we can all look at someone and say, oh, she's confident, you know, she speaks loudly, she's on TV, she's in a bather, she's confident. But what it is the courage that it takes to do that.
Mm.
And then we break it down and we start to see that courage comes in all forms. So courage can be wearing a bold lip for the first time, mm-hmm. wearing your bathers, but courage can also be, hey, I'm struggling, I need a bit of help, or I want to go after that career, or I want to be the best mum that I could possibly be. That takes courage to say that and be vocal about it.
Mm.
So then all of a sudden, we start seeing these daily acts of courage, we start piecing them together, and then we're confident about who we are, what we want to do, where we want to be. Does that...
And you mentioned being a mum, so you've got three kids. So how important is it that you teach them about body positivity?
It's really important. You know, it's really important to teach them about body positivity, but I talk about it in a different light. I talk about being fit and strong and healthy. Mm. So we don't talk about, you know, body sizes and body shapes. And the word body positivity, I don't mention a lot at home. What I talk about is, oh, my goodness, you're so fit to be able to do that at gymnastics. And Taekwondo is so fun. And I saw you run after that soccer ball. You know, those kind of things, that's what you should be striving for, to be healthy in your body.
Have you always been this confident? Because I think especially mums in particular have a really uneasy relationship with their bodies after kids. Is this something that you had to really work at, or had you always had this?
Well, I've always had a bubbly personality. I've always been a go-getter and someone will get out there and do anything and give anything a go. But I think your confidence it goes in ebbs and flows, right? Mm. You take a dive. I remember when I had my first baby, I went to 130 kilos. You know, I was quite big and I still dressed beautifully. I still went swimming. I was still in my bathers, but it was weird. It was like my body was different, you know, and how do I work this out? And then, you know, you're breastfeeding in the summertime and it's hot and I'm uncomfortable. And
you smell like sour milk.
Exactly, you know. And so you do have these times where your confidence will take these little dips, and then you've got to work out, and it's about going back to those daily acts of courage. What can I do today that will just bring me out of that a little bit, just a little bit?
Is there anywhere that you wouldn't rock a swimsuit?
I feel like that is a challenging question. No.
Oh, really?
Yeah, definitely.
Cue the Shania Twain then.
All right, see, I'm gonna do this. I'm tucked in all the right places. Oh my goodness. All right, here we go. Now,
gorgeous.
Shall we move over there? I will give you a strut.
trust, all right. Definitely. All right. Oh, but as girl. I do, I'm going to tie this up here.
Yes.
All right. Oh, my goodness.
You are fabulous. Oh, I love you, Emmylou.
This is so cheeky.
Okay, you've got some great little steps. Let's give her a round of applause first.
Let's warm me up a bit.
Girl, you are fine. Tell us about the little tips and tricks if we want to build our body confidence. Heading into summer, heading to the beach, you don't have to go full brave to begin with. There are little steps you can take.
Exactly. So, firstly, a tan. You know, I'm all about sun safe, so I don't soak out in the sun. You know, so a nice fresh tan is going to make you feel great. There are so many different tans, even on those emergency ones, you know, where you don't realise you're going to be headed out. I mean, I brought a self-tan for a 9-minute self-tan the other day, which 9 minutes, that's all you need. So that will help boost your confidence straight away.
My motto is, what you can't tone, tan.
Exactly. Tan will take 5 kilos off your arms underneath, straight
100%.
Away.
Heels?
The other thing, heels. So heels, this is for when it's wintertime, right? So think about resort wear. So think about strutting around the resort and you're just feeling a little bit like, oh, I haven't been in my bathers, you know, for the last couple of months, you feel a bit awkward. So putting on something like a wedge will work really well. Not just a heel, a wedge, because that's going to give you the support to walk around the pool and not think you're going to fall over straight away. Mm-hmm. Now, if you're still feeling a little awkward, get a caftan. Get a kimono, get something that is nice and light, makes you feel really feminine, really fresh, and then all of a sudden you're walking around, you've got movement as well. And don't forget that the wedges, they push your butt out. They, you know, they give you a little bit of shape as well. So there's nothing wrong with wanting to have a holiday photo.
Exactly. Yeah. And you know what? You don't want to make these decisions now. And when you're, you know, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years down the track, go, man, I wish I'd done that. Emmylou, you are such a treasure. Oh. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much.
Here it is, girl.
That was so much fun. Thank you.
We love you. Come back anytime.